as a head coach in the National Hockey League.
That's a bad hit by Hemsky. That's a bad hit. And you know what? In that case, Mick, you can't blame Jonathan Erickson just for giving it to him.
You should. Did he get thrown out? I don't think so, did he?
No. But he is angry.
Edlery would be okay, and there was no penalty on the play.
Or should they be? Alex Edler doesn't move at all. Hurdle tries to jump around him.
Put out 6 feet away from him. Yeah, they're having a confab down here, all four officials. And an explanation to Chara, so when you see that, it makes you think that it's more than two.
Yeah, match penalty, which requires review. Interference.
Trouba steps up right here.
Wow.
And the shoulder clips the head.
And will this be more than two? Well, Stone's been through this before. Last year was a Bufflin hit. Good to see him get up as quickly as that. And Guy Boucher can't believe it's only two.
Yeah, he is hot down here.
Watch as he dishes this puck off. Oh, boy. That is a brutal elbow from Brandon Dubinsky, and it's right on the jaw of Saku Koivu. Point of contact, the head of Koivu, and I think this is going to be at least a minor penalty.
Well, the officials have circled the wagons on the near side of the ice.
I'm right with you, Craig. So far, the referees haven't even huddled to talk about it. They're standing over Chris Letang after that hit.
Boy, already as advertised, though, the speed of this game and the turnovers at one end up with chances at the other.
Wes McCauley, Francis Charron, the referees, joined by Johnny Murray and Greg Dvorsky to huddle and talk about this big hit.
Defending Stanley Cup champion that has won three in a row. Lucic over the line to Chatan, the shot up high, it goes over Fleury's goal. And Chatan is down in the high slot, and I did not see it. I was following the puck, Brick, but tempers are rising down in the corner. Don Del Negro is out to administer to Miroslav Chatan.
He got the back diagonal pass from Milan Lucic, and it was Cook that was coming in on the back check from the blind side, and I believe it was Cook ended up making contact with Savard.
Crosby, PJ and I were saying this could be a concussion.
Well, as he's going by, he thought I'd give him a little shot. I mean, and you can't blame the guy. I'm going by, what he hit his head, eh? And I'm going to tell you, if he doesn't have a good concussion, I don't know what is, and that's that bit, that's those, look at the size of the shoulder pads on the guy. It's just like armor, and he got a full tilt, and he is hurt. I'll bet you.
What you would have imagined. See, there's Gino off his feet there to engage with Wheeler. And Stewart, the man who cleared the puck, gets right into Malkin's face. Wheeler finally get up and join the ruckus in front of the Penguins bench. And this after the Penguins have lost two defensemen to hits. And Wheeler's got to go for protocol to the dressing room after the Penguins have lost two defensemen with some questionable hits.
In and out to center, led by Jokinen up over the line. Borges, low shot, stopped by Andrew Hammond. And the Florida player dumped at the far side as UC Jokinen, and he was hurt.
And here comes the hit there, head contact.
Count to the box, Greg.
And it looks late because that's not real speed, and often that can be deceiving, but it certainly is contact to the head, and that's why Cowan's going to the penalty box.
Three-game slide as they came into this one. Look out! Oh, head down and a big hit, and it's Gudas again, and here comes the cavalry, and the sticks and gloves are off, and here we go! Jake McCabe's going to take on Gudas, and we'll watch away from this scrap as McCabe has his jersey pulled up top of over his head, and the linesman need to get into that situation, and he's taken down to the ice.
Gudas targeted him. He realized that Catenaccio was in a bad position. And you watch, I watched him come right from the blue line here, right in front of us, and he targeted him. And the referee was making the initial call on Gudas. And that's twice so far tonight. Watch this. Catenaccio's in a bad spot. Gudas steps right up.
That is vicious.
No need for him to do that. He's already tied up with another Philadelphia Flyer. There's no need for him to step in right there, and he catches him.